audience complain. You can imagine. Well, I have two puppets. They're actually my family. Okay, they travel with me everywhere I go. They're actually in that suitcase over there. There's my cousin Johnny Vegas. He actually believes that he's Dean Martin and Frank Sinatra. Now he only talks to me, but he lip syncs. He'll be up on stage shortly. He has his own microphone. Grandpa Gus, well, you'll meet him a little later on. He's sleeping right now. He sleeps a lot. But you know, Johnny, we go way back, eh? Because we, you know, he is my cousin, eh? And he actually believes he's at the Sands Hotel in Las Vegas, the Copa Room. Now, I haven't had the heart to tell him that the Copa Room, the Sands Hotel, was torn down years ago. But I said to him, I said, Johnny, remember the last time we were in Vegas and you ran out of money at the casino and I lent you $100? And he says, no, Mike, I don't remember that. I said, well, I did lend you the money. He says, well, you know what they say, Mike? I said, what's that, Johnny? What happens in Vegas stays in Vegas. So that's what happened to my $100, I guess. Now, he actually believes he travels all over North America performing. So I said to him, I said, Johnny, must cost a lot for airfare. He says, well, not really. I said, what do you mean? He says, only $59. I said, that's really cheap. He says, yeah, I go as carry-on luggage. So, Johnny, I'm kind of worried about him, man, because he's delusional, and I'm sure he has a multiple personality disorder. So I called the psychiatrist. I got to talk to his nurse, and I said, I'd like to bring my cousin in. And I explained the problem. She says, well, we can take him right this afternoon. I said, well, it is fairly severe. So we get in there, so there's a psychiatrist, and he says, well, where's your cousin Johnny? So I take him out of the suitcase, right? Psychiatrist looks at him. He says, yeah. So he talks to Johnny for 5 minutes, and I told him, I said, Johnny will only talk to me. He says, okay. He says, look, I can assure you Johnny is okay. I said, oh, that's a relief. He says, however, I'd like you to come back here every Tuesday at 2 o'clock. So I made a new friend. So that was wonderful. Now, I expected Johnny to be here, oh, a month ago. He arrives yesterday in Ottawa. So I picked him up at the airport, one bag. So I said, Johnny, where have you been? He says, well, I've been on a world tour. I said, really? That's wonderful. Tell me all about it. Went to Hong Kong, Melbourne, Australia. Went to London, England, Paris, France, Berlin, Germany, Moscow, back to London, New York, Toronto, then Ottawa. I said, you must have one heck of an agent. He's not really. I flew Air Canada and they lost my luggage. What can I say? Well, Johnny's in his, well, he thinks it's his dressing room, eh? I'm gonna go check on him.
Well, hello there. This is Jimmy Stewart. I'd like to introduce you to a little fellow I met in Las Vegas when I was working on a motion picture. Now, his name is Johnny. Well, he had a few drinks and he invited me to see his show. Now, he'd not only be 28 inches tall, see, but don't let that fool you. He's the darndest little entertainer I've ever had the pleasure of meeting, see? I see he's here with his grandpa, too. Okay, Johnny, there's some folks that want to meet you. Well, I'll let you folks decide for yourselves. Johnny, I'll look you up the next time I pass this way again. And be good to your grandpa now.
Show, A Man and His Music. The music of Count Basie and his great band.
You're gonna have to work this club more often.
Yeah.
I get no kick from champagne. Mere alcohol, it doesn't move me at all. So tell me, why should it be true that I get a kick out of you? Some like the Bob type refrain. I'm sure that if I heard even one riff, twould bore me terrifically too. Yet I'd get a kick out of you. I get a kick every time I see you standing there before me. I get a kick, though it's clear to me you obviously don't adore me. I get no kick in a plane, flying too high with some gal in the sky is my idea of nothing to do. Yet I get a kick out of you.
Hey, stop that.
I get a kick every time I see you standing there before me. I get a kick, though it's clear to me you obviously do not adore me. I get no kick in a plane, flying too high with some gal in the sky is my idea of nothing to do. Yet I get a kick, yes, I get a kick, yes, I get a kick out of you.
You gonna do a little Dean Martin for us? Great. You sat in the front row, didn't you? Enliven things up.
I kissed her and she kissed me. We got a kick in the hand. The room was completely black. She hugged back like the sailor said, quote, ain't that a hole in the boat? To sleep and keep grinning. If this is just the beginning, my life is gonna be beautiful. I've sunshine up this place. It's just like the fella said,
Tell me quick, ain't love a kick in my head? Said, ain't that a kick in the head? Like a sailor said, quote, ain't that a hole in a boat? My head keeps spinning. I'd go to sleep if you're in it. If this is just the beginning, my life is gonna be beautiful. She's telling me we'll be well. She's picked out a king size bed.
Johnny, you're tiring me out. It's getting awful hot in here. That's the end of Johnny's show for this evening. I think Grandpa is already awake. Oh, wait a second. What? Hey, look. Look who's here.
Oh, hi, Johnny. I see you just finished your show. Funniest thing, I was going out the door, and the prettiest little lady came up to me and wanted to know if she could show me around. Well, how could a fellow refuse an offer like that? Well, let me tell you, this is quite the place, all right. Think I might stay here for a while. Hey, Johnny, how about I buy you a drink? You must be thirsty after your show. Come on, let's go.
Thank you, I'll be back in a second. Hey, Grandpa, is he gonna wake up? Grandpa!
Grandpa!
What the heck's going on here? What? Who are all these folks? Well, I came here to see you. I don't want to see anyone tonight. I don't want to be... Grandpa, what? You're not wearing any socks. What? That's right. And I'm not wearing any underwear either. Oh, well, you don't have to be mean about it. So, did you work in Florida? Well, of course I worked in Florida. What do you think I... Oh, geez. You were never my favorite grandson. Okay. I like Johnny better. Hey, Johnny. So what did you do for work in Florida? Well, I did work for an orange juice company. Yeah? What happened there? Got canned. Just got that, eh? Why did they fire you? They said I couldn't concentrate. Settle down over there. This could go on for a long time. Okay. Well, what else did you do for work? Well, I worked as a taste tester in a prune juice factory. Really? That sounds terrible. Best job I ever had. Why is that? One day on and 3 days off. You're gonna bruise yourself. I'm okay. Sheesh, I don't know. I hear you got a new girlfriend.
Yep.
What's her name? Rose. That's a beautiful name.
Yep.
Well, is she good looking?
Ugly as sin.
Is she a good cook?
I eat out all the time.
Well, is she a good housekeeper?
I never want to have my friends over. I'm so ashamed.
Oh, that's terrible. My goodness. Well, why do you stay with her?
She still has her driver's license.
Oh, goodness. Well, that's a good reason, I guess. Oh.
You know, when I was young...
Well, I don't know, because I was born yet.
Yeah? Don't be silly.
Okay.
For a dollar, I could go in the store and get a pound of bacon, pound of butter, loaf of bread, and sugar. For a dollar.
Oh, I don't believe that.
Yeah, well, you can't do that today. You know why? Too many surveillance cameras.
That's true, eh? Oh, yeah.
Remember when I took you fishing?
Oh, yes, this is a good one, folks.
Yep. What I said was, Mike, would you like to go fishing?
And I was only 5 years old, of course.
Grandpa, Grandpa, please, please take me fishing. Yes, that's what you said.
So we went to the hardware store, got the bamboo pole for 25 cents. Some of you can remember that. Green fishing line.
Mm-hmm.
Hooks.
Mm-hmm.
Went home and I collected worms from rocks and logs and put them in that rusty can.
That's right, that's what he did. Mm-hmm.
Put those worms beside my bed. I didn't sleep all night.
That's right.
Next morning after breakfast, what happened?
I said, Mike, time to go fishing, yippee! So we walked down to the boat. The lake was just over there. Rowed out to the middle of the lake and I said, Mike, now you're gonna learn to swim. And I threw you in the lake. You learned to swim, didn't you?
Yeah, but you know what the hard part was?
What was that?
Getting out of that burlap bag.
My hand's getting away from me again.
Well, hold on a second. You wouldn't quit moving around like that. Is that any better?
Well, I don't know.
Sheesh. Hey, do you remember when I was a kid and I asked you to croak like a frog?
Yeah, I remember that. Ticked me right off. Kept harping at it. Croak like a frog, Grandpa. Croak like a frog.
Remember what happened?
Yeah, finally I said, Mike, why do you want me to croak like a frog?
And what did I say?
You said, Grandma says that when Grandpa croaks, we can go to Disneyland. Still haven't gone to Disneyland, have you?
No. Your memory's not very good, so what I've done, I won't call them idiot cards.
Well, you better not.
Yeah, okay.
Okay, you can pick that up now.
Here, Grandpa.
Thanks. She's a real cutie. What's your name, sweetie?
Yeah.
Hello? What's your name?
Carol.
Oh!
Watch your heart, watch your heart.
I'm in love again. Carol, Carol.
I told you to leave the ladies alone. She could be married.
Oh, she's not married.
Well, how do you know?
She looks happy. How come only the ladies laughed at that one? Sheesh.
Oh, I don't know.
Well, Carol, I could be your sugar daddy. No, it's true.
But Grandpa.
What? Don't get in the middle of this one.
Okay. Grandpa, you don't have any money.
Carol. But I got diabetes. Get it? Sugar daddy.
There, put your glasses on.
jumping. I thought there was only 3 or 4 people here. And you said you had friends. Do you know any of these folks?
Not really.
Yeah, you don't have any friends. Okay,
smart person. What I've done is I made some, I won't call them idiot cards.
You better not.
They're jokes, because he can't remember them. So you read the joke. No, out loud.
Why is there no gambling in Africa?
I don't know, why is there no gambling in Africa?
There's too many cheetahs. Get it? Cheaters. Cheaters.
Yeah, I think they got it.
You think so? They're a lot slower than you are, Mike. What lies at the bottom of the ocean and twitches?
What lies at the bottom of the ocean and twitches?
Anyone? Carol? Anyone?
What lies at the bottom of the ocean and twitches?
A nervous wreck! After the joke. What do you call cheese that isn't yours?
So what do you call cheese that isn't yours?
Nacho cheese!